Good morning, students. I will show you few more cases of concave mirror. We can take now object between center of curvature and focus. Let's see where the image is formed. You have to draw one mirror, pole of the mirror, then it is center and focus. So this is where the position of the object is. As per the rules, we will be taking the two rays, one pattern which will pass through focus, another ray can be taken which is passing through the focus, which after parallel will become, after reflection it will become parallel. You can see the position of the image which is beyond C. So we can get some information about the image. First, that it is forming beyond C, the size is bigger than the object, and the nature is real and inverted. Next is, when the object is placed at focus, object is at F, which is called focus of the mirror. This is pole, center, and this is focus. We will take this as the object, lying exactly at the focus. One ray is parallel, which after reflection will pass through the focus. Another ray, what we are going to take, is the ray passing through focus. So let us suppose this is the ray which is passing through focus. Now you find these two rays will not be meeting very close to the mirror, instead they will be meeting at infinity. So we can say the position of the image will be at infinity. It will always be bigger than the object, and the nature will always be real and inverted. And the last case for the concave mirror will be when the object is placed between pole and focus of the mirror. Between pole and focus. So we have this, and you should know this is only the case where you find concave mirror forming virtual and erect image. This is pole, center, focus, and the object is between pole and focus. We will take two rays. One ray is parallel to the principal axis, which after reflection will become or will pass through the focus. The second ray we can take, which is passing through center of curvature. So after reflection, it will come along the same line. Now if you see these two rays, they are not going to meet anywhere in front of the mirror. See, the rays are getting backwards only every time. So to make the two rays meet, we need to produce the two rays back. So let us suppose these are the two rays which when produced back is found to be meeting at certain point. So this becomes the position of the image which is behind the mirror. You can see the size of the image is, it is much bigger than the object, and the nature this time will be virtual and erect. So we have this much about the concave mirror. Next we can see one image that will be formed using the convex mirror. Convex mirror will always form virtual and erect image. and the position of the image will always be between pole and focus. So we have the image formed by convex mirror. This we can take it as a convex mirror, and this is the principal axis. We have taken one object in front of the mirror. One ray can be taken parallel to the principal axis, which will become or which will pass through the focus, but this time it won't be able to pass through the focus because this will be reflected, but it gets reflected in such a manner that it appears to pass through focus. The second ray what we can take is the ray passing through the center of curvature. We have this as the center of curvature. The original ray cannot pass through the center of curvature, but it falls on the mirror as if it appears to pass through the center of curvature. So this is the direction of the ray and it will be reflected along the same line. Now you can see the two rays are meeting between pole and focus. And if you compare the size of this image, it looks always smaller than this. And this is one of the reasons why this mirror is used as a rear view mirror in vehicles, because it always forms an image which is smaller than the object. I hope it is clear to you. Next day we will see something more about the mirror. Till then, thank you.